Utah Senator Mitt Romney is not going to be running for re-election. So naturally, he is releasing a tell-all book, a biography. And some of the information he's releasing in that book is unsurprising, yet extremely concerning. Now, one of the biggest revelations coming out is that most Republicans voted not to impeach Donald Trump because they were afraid of political violence from his supporters. The biographer McKay Coppins spoke with Vanity Fair and stated, "One of the biggest revelations to me in my conversations with Romney was just how important the threat of political violence was to the psychology of elected Republicans today." And again, that's something that we've all seen play out. But to hear it from someone with, you know, insider information who actually would know the thoughts and the feelings of these politicians, it is frightening. Now, Coppins also revealed in that interview that while writing the biography, Romney told him story after story about Republican members of Congress, Republican senators who at various points wanted to vote for impeachment, vote to convict Trump, or vote to impeach Trump and decided not to. Not because they thought he was innocent, but because they were afraid for their family's safety. They were afraid of what Trump supporters might do to them or to their families. Now, the details Coppins has revealed paint a horrifying picture of the stranglehold that the Trump supporter cult has on the Republican Party and Republican politicians themselves. And it really shouldn't be a surprise after we heard Trump supporters chanting, "Hang Mike Pence," on January 6th, that Republicans are afraid that they will be the victims of similar calls for violence or violence itself if they oppose Trump. Now, political violence is also, and I hate to have to point this out, but I do, gaining popularity, particularly among Republicans. Let's go to this report from Time. It was put out yesterday. A full 1/3 or 33% of Republicans say that violence may be the answer. That is ahead of the 22% of independents and 13% of Democrats who agree. But across the board, those numbers are trending in a dangerous direction. And first asked in 2021, 28% of Republicans saw the virtues of political violence, 13% of independents concurred, and 7% of Democrats shared that perspective. And you won't be shocked to learn that among supporters of Donald Trump, members of the MAGA cult, that number is higher. Among those who have a favorable view of ex-president Donald Trump, who sparked the failed insurrection on January 6th to keep him in power, there is a threefold multiplier for the merits of violence, reaching 41% support among pro-Trump Americans. That's almost half. That's almost half of all Trump supporters that believe political violence is going to be necessary. Not just that it's fine, but that it might be necessary. And those people were well represented on January 6th. So, Senator Turner, my first thoughts on this are, one, Mitt Romney is an unmitigated coward. I'm sorry for waiting to reveal this information until his political career is over. I mean, he did take some stances opposing the Republican Party, opposing Donald Trump, but this is something that would have been helpful for the American people to have been clued into just before he was halfway out the door.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of cowards in that Congress. He's not by himself, but you're right. I mean, he was safe. A lot of people who are absolutely safe, because sometimes for political reasons, I get people may want to be a little more tactical, a little more strategic. But when it comes to people like Senator Mitt Romney, he could afford to have a little more courage than what he showed. And the point you made about, I had that right in, at the top of mind about, yeah, they should fear. They had every right to be fearful because, yes, the vice president was threatened. They threatened to lynch the vice president. You had President Trump not coming to the rescue of his own vice president. We see how they comported themselves on January the 6th. So it makes a whole lot of sense, both physical violence and also political violence too. Because when you go against the MAGA, you know, they make sure that there's consequences and repercussions to the people that they put in office. Unlike those on the progressive left, I think should hold people more accountable, certainly not in a violent way. Mm-hmm. But it's not surprising to me, and I can't wait to hear what David has to say about this. It's not surprising to me that Republican electeds are being held captive, basically, by the Donald Trump type Republicans, and they're fearing for their political lives and sometimes their physical lives as well.
Yeah, and we saw just over the last week, right, in the speakership battle, there was Jim Jordan when he was up for speaker, and then his supporters gave office numbers of the people who were sort of wavering on Jim Jordan, and all of a sudden, a lot of families, a lot of members of Congress's spouses started getting death threats. These are Republicans giving death threats to other Republicans, and sometimes we think, oh, this is just directed at Democrats, but no, they're also incredibly bloodthirsty and vicious with each other. And I was just in New Hampshire a couple of days ago, and you keep hearing over and over from the Trump crowd how much they can't stand rhinos, that in some ways they hate rhinos more than I think maybe some Democrats, because they feel like a Republican in name only is only as a betrayal if you're an establishment Republican. The numbers are sickening. I just hope that maybe there are more situations like we saw with Speaker Jordan where it boomerangs, where if somebody is engaged in violence. I think one of the reasons that Jordan didn't become House Speaker is because so many moderate Republicans were so infuriated at these threats that they were like, I'm not going to support you. Well, we need that to sort of now move across the board. And we need both Democrats and Republicans to be able to say, look, anybody who's engaging in violence has no business being in the public sphere, has no business having a voice on any of this.